Alright, so this is the progress so far. I kind of screwed up and forgot to take a video, but we got this side deck, we got this cylinder. Let's see if it'll focus. Come on. There we go. We got the cylinder all cross-hatched, honed out. There you go. That's what it looks like before. They're pretty clean, but I like to they call it deglaze. So the block has been painted, all cleaned up. Yeah, nice. And Oliver, this is for you. This is Uncle Mickey. When he was young and handsome before he got old and fat.
That's right. Before I got old and fat. You know that's you, right?
Hey!
Hey!
I don't want to get too far ahead of myself, but I've been working on this thing. So the crankshaft is in, and the oilers are all in. Everything's torqued to spec. The main cap side bolts are in. I got the, this is called the reluctor. This whole set of three, the main cam bearing. Main cam, like front main seal rides on this surface right here. Oil pump is on. I gotta torque this right now and do that. The camshaft is in. So once this portion is done, I'm gonna go ahead and start working. I'll flip this over and start working on the lifters and stuff. Because I was planning on putting all the pistons on my rings, or rings on my pistons and everything, but somebody took the tool home with him. Oops. Set of rings going on.
You say the last set of rings are going on?
I did.
Cletus.
Hell yeah, brother. You're on the Cletus McFarland YouTube channel. So
but you ain't.
Huh?
But you ain't.
But you ain't. That's right. You gotta run a 754 and a quarter mile to
be on that channel.
To get there. Invitation to the Freedom Factory.
know how to use that thing?
What's that?
If you know how to use that thing?
I don't know, but it is right now, so I'm not clocked in.
So right now we are putting in the ARP head studs. So these have an Allen head on one side and then a solid on the other. That's the block side. So, ARP calls for their high temp ARP thread sealant, but I found some Hermatex at the local auto parts store. I bought a kit with ARP head studs in it, and they sent me the assembly lube for torquing, but they didn't send me anything for the sealant. So, kind of a little bit weird to require a special sealant and not have it in the box, but it is what it is. I think this is gonna be fine. And I'm only putting these in a few threads in order to get it started, and then I'm going to come back with the impact and just run them down right before they, like, I'm not like ramming them into the block, but that way I don't have to sit here and thread each one by hand. These are supposed to just be hand tight, so I'll get them close and then I'll back it off a little bit and then just snug it up with my hand. All right. Okay, so that's all done.
I'm gonna clean up the block surface one more time to get some of that sealant off of there. Use a clean rag. Get a sip of coffee. Okay. All right, so heads are on, torqued, got the push rods in. I put assembly grease on everything as I'm putting it together. The top of the valve stems all have assembly grease on them, so I'm gonna go ahead and start, I'm gonna put the bridges on, and then I will probably put the injectors in, and then the rocker assembly. So each of these injectors has a rubber O-ring that runs around the actual tube. That O-ring needs to seat inside of the injector cup that's in the head. So, and I've, from what I've been told, you don't really want to pull that injector down into the tube with this hold down. Otherwise, it can actually like pinch that O-ring and you end up with a bigger problem later on. So, just a little tidbit there. So these injector hold down bolts here get torqued to 39 foot-pounds, which I'm already at. So glow plugs. On these Duramaxes, apparently the glow plugs have a huge tendency to break off in the head, and in order to remove them, you have to take your head to a head shop, which means you have to do, you know, head gaskets, like basically a full head gasket job. So I always assemble these with anti-seize on them to make sure that I can get these out. Since these are aluminum heads, you don't really want to be breaking stuff off and having to get it out and machining and all that stuff. Thank you. And I just use German torque specs on these. Good and tight. Okay. Make sure those are all on so I don't lose that. Now we're gonna take our assembly lube and we're gonna make sure that each one of these gets a little dollop. Okay, I think we can go ahead and put the rocker assembly on. Here, I'm gonna take a 13, 14. Bust all these loose. Since these are new heads, or not new, but remanned heads. And the valve seats have been ground. The old valve settings don't matter, and we're gonna make sure that everything is all clearanced and everything properly anyway when we reassemble. So that'll be here pretty soon. So I just back these all off as far as they'll go. So on the valve train, seeing as all of these specs need to stay where I set them, and I don't want any of this loosening up. I'm using a little bit of blue Loctite on these. So there is a tightening sequence for these and a torque spec. So these need to be at 30 foot-pounds. And this is number one for tightening. Okay, and then it's 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, torqued, Loctited, all assembly lubed. So on these injection return lines, I replaced there's little washers in here, like a banjo bolt washer that goes on this side, and it's got a band that goes between and it goes to the other side. So it's like a two-piece washer for the top and the bottom. Same thing as what's on this one. And I replaced all of that and I replaced it with new banjo bolts on all this as well, because I guess they have a tendency to strip out. Stock ones didn't really give me any trouble, but I'm gonna go ahead and replace them, or I went ahead and replaced them anyway, just to make sure that I don't have to deal with it later. And then a 12 mil for the actual return line bolt up here.